Great Scott.
I need you to help me find this car from this photo and get it to Michael.
This is for Michael.
So is that a yes?
All right, I'm in.
Yes! Josh Gates and Christopher Lloyd.
ID, please.
Oh, that's Christopher Lloyd.
You got a real attitude problem, Gates. Slackers.
There wasn't just one car. There were seven.
We got to figure out where the other six cars are. Can you do a quick search on your phone?
Yeah. What numbers do you want me to put?
Oh, boy. This is the letter that Marty writes to Doc. The plutonium! You're telling me this sucker's nuclear? You ready to hit the road and get this thing to Michael?
Roads. Well, we're going, we don't
need. It doesn't fly, Chris.
Oh, then we definitely need roads.
Yeah, okay. Here we go. I don't mind, but you better promise me I'll be back in time. Hey, you want to hear my Doc Brown impression?
No.
Marty!
Hi.
One, two, three.
Marchy McFly, Marchy McFly. Marchy McFly is Marchy McFly. Marchy McFly is Marchy McFly.
Day 15. Can you believe it? We're here, ladies and gentlemen. It's day 15, and it's early on a Monday morning. I'm on vacation, folks, so we're going to get a few early episodes of Marchy McFly this week, and today I thought I'd do something a little different. I watched Back to the Future with breakfast this morning. Already done. Bing, bang, boom. And as much as I'm talking about Back to the Future, I thought I'd do something slightly different and talk about something that talks about Back to the Future. Today, on Discovery Plus, premiered a brand new show, a reality show, a Discovery-like, you know, adventure, not not a reality show, really, just kind of like a discovery show where, you know, they look for stuff. So there's this guy who does expedition. Maybe he does expedition history. I don't know him from a hole in the wall. Never heard of him before. The show sounds kind of familiar. From my understanding, I brought up the show and my brother says, oh, his wife hates this guy's voice. I didn't even know he existed. This guy's name is Josh Gates. I thought his voice was okay. Maybe we'll see after multiple episodes. But what timing that on March 15th, 2021, that's today, the 15th of Marchy McFly, they premiere a brand new show on Discovery's new streaming platform called Expedition Back to the Future. It consists of four 40-minute episodes. I don't think there's anything more than that. I think it's just going to be these four episodes, and all four are out there now for you to check out. And again, I think Discovery Plus, they're not a sponsor of this show. Nobody's a sponsor of the show. Discovery Plus is, I think you can sign up for a free week. I was like, I want to sign up now. I thought the show would go on maybe for 8 weeks. I didn't know if it was daily. I don't know what it was. So I signed up last week. My wife uses this now to watch all those 90 Day Fiancé fiascos. They have all these extra reality shows. Look, I love my wife. She's my best friend. I just told her yesterday that I love making people laugh, but I love making her laugh the most. Isn't that sweet? But she watches the crappiest television. And we have such a small crossover with our TV. Like, I think we watched the last show we hardcore watched together. Well, that doesn't sound right. But we watched crazy was Friday Night Lights. We watched that a couple of years ago. We tried to do it with Riverdale. We made it through the first season. I'm trying to get her to watch Ted Lasso because everyone loves that. And I think that'd be a show we watch together. We watched The Amazing Race together. The Great Food Truck Race. Does that count? That's a food show on Food Network. What else did we watch together? We watched that terrible 90210 reboot. Oh my God, that was awful. But we watched every episode together. Other than that, she loves these reality shows, The Housewives, The 90 Day Fiancé, The Married at First Sights. And for the most part, the only reality shows I enjoy are competition shows where, you know, Amazing Race is a crossover. We watch that. I love Survivor. She doesn't care about that. But I like when they compete for making food, when they compete to anything competing. I can get into. But this one's a little different. This one is just kind of, it's almost a documentary. It's almost a love letter. It is a love letter to Back to the Future. That's what this really is. It's a love letter to some old Hollywood stuff and specifically to Back to the Future. And they kind of created this fake little story around it. At least as far as I know, it's a fake little story. I only watched the first episode, and I thought I'd talk about that today. I have no notes in front of me. I'm not even sitting at my computer. I am lying on my couch. I'm kind of lying like, do you remember in that episode of The Office where Michael Scott is lying on the hope chest because Jan takes up the bed and Michael Scott lies on the hope chest? He's got his legs like crooked. That's how I am lying right now. And I have to tell you, it's pretty comfortable. I have my little portable recorder and I have my microphone plugged into it, which actually sounds pretty nice. Sounds better than like plugging just into my computer because that gets so much feedback. But this, I think, sounds a little nicer. So anyway, I just finished watching it. It's 40 minutes long, the first episode. I didn't watch the other three because I don't want this to be just a full review of this show. I just wanted to tell you about this first episode and kind of give you an idea of what it is. Now, this is going to be spoilers, so if you don't want to talk or hear about the show at all, I would stop listening now. But really, it's the idea of the show is looking for all the DeLoreans. They built a premise around it that this guy Josh is out doing his regular expedition show, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Doc Brown shows up. Yes, Doc Brown, not Christopher Lloyd. Doc Brown. Christopher Lloyd. I feel like Christopher Lloyd loves Doc Brown so much, he will use any excuse. He will never not dress up as Doc Brown. I mean, we're talking, this is 36 years later. I don't know when they filmed this. I don't know if they did it. You know, nobody's wearing masks. Nobody's talking about social distancing. So I'm guessing this was maybe done in 2019 or done very safely. I don't know. Christopher Lloyd's 81 years old. Please be safe with him. He's a national treasure. But the premise is this guy's filming something and all of a sudden back to the Doc Brown shows up in a modified Tesla. And they're like, you made the time machine out of a Tesla? He's like, no, it's an upgrade or modifications or whatever it was. And he says, listen, something needs to be done. He shows this newspaper to the guy, and it shows, he goes, this handsome older man, Christopher Lloyd, the guy hosting the show, Josh, and Michael J. Fox are all standing on a stage with a DeLorean behind them. And then it says, a DeLorean is auctioned off for record money for the Michael J. Fox Foundation. I think this whole show is kind of geared towards promoting the Michael J. Fox Foundation. So it's all even for a good cause. So they're like, you need to find this DeLorean because the DeLorean's starting to disappear in the photo. It's starting to be erased from existence. So they need to find that DeLorean and make sure it gets to the auction so that it gets auctioned off. So that's the quote unquote premise of the show. So this guy goes and searches out the actual Christopher Lloyd. So it's the show is this guy, Josh Gates and Christopher Lloyd. They're going along for the show. Christopher Lloyd, 81 years old, you know, his delivery sounds a little more like Jim Igdentowski now. Like he's a little slowed down because he's 81, but he's still with it. He's still got it. And it's still great to see him, you know, with his wild eyes and his, you know, his little sarcasm. I'm not sure I pronounced that right. But anyway, so he goes up, picks Christopher Lloyd up, and the rest of the show is them trying to find the right DeLorean. They meet up with, and along the way, we get little cameos from original Back to the Future actors. So they go to the Universal set, and the security guard is Mr. Strickland, James Tolkien himself. He's got, even his badge says Strickland on it. And they go to, they're at the Universal backlot, which is where the movie was made. And they go to meet Bob Gale there to talk about the DeLorean. Bob Gale, of course, the co-writer, producer, creator of Back to the Future. And they meet with him at a diner. Of course, I think it's Lou's Diner. And I want to talk a little, I did take one note about Lou's Diner. I'm going to talk about that in a second. So, or after this, you know, I'll talk about it now. But first, while they're in Lou's Diner talking to Bob Gale, a guy comes up who works at the diner. And who is it? It's the actual actor who played Goldie Wilson. First of all, everyone kept together pretty good. Like, Goldie Wilson looks older, but you still know it's Goldie Wilson right away. Don Fullilove, if I pronounce it right, I'm not sure, but we see him. And again, he's just doing a little cameo. They talk to Bob Gale, and they're like, you need to go to this museum. So we see a lot of cool things, a lot of like, oh, look at this automotive museum. This has Back to the Future. It has the original car completely restored. It looks gorgeous. Christopher Lloyd gets into it. I mean, this is definitely a scripted, like, you know, their talk back and forth. I feel like there's a lot of things they're scripted. But some points you feel like Christopher Lloyd's really reacting to sitting in this DeLorean. It's pretty cool. Then they're like, okay, great. This is the car. Can we have it? And the guy's like, no, this belongs to Universal. You can't have it. So Christopher Lloyd is thinking we need to, you know, come back later and steal the car. It's pretty funny. And so they go, no, we can't. And we got to figure out another idea. So they're like, Christopher Lloyd, they're driving along. He's like, I know what to do. They pull over, they go to this house. It's Leah Thompson. So we get to see Leah Thompson. She looks great. She, you know, like 36 years later, she still looks like Leah Thompson to me. And she shows off that she still has the dress, the original dress. So she said there were three dresses from the Enchantment Under the Sea dance, and she got to keep one of them, or she kept one of them. And when she, when they made part two, they lost the other dresses. So she took her dress and brought that back to wear for the dance. So that was pretty cool. She's still working today. Like, she was on a show. What was it? Separated at Birth. It was an ABC Family show, which is now Freeform. That she was on that the whole time. She directs now. I see her name on sitcoms all the time. Like the show, The Goldbergs. She directed a bunch of episodes of that, a bunch of different shows. So that was kind of cool. And she's like, wait, you came to talk to me about this? I was in like one scene with a DeLorean. I never got inside it. I didn't even see the car. It was covered up. And they're interspersing cuts of the movie. I mean, this really is, really all it is a love letter to Back to the Future. I've said that a million times. While also looking for props and looking at old Hollywood props. And that is like so up my alley. I love this. So they go from Leah Thompson. She's like, oh, you should go to the museum. Like, we did that. She goes, no. You need to go to the Hollywood Museum. I'm pretty sure they have one, too. They're like, what? So, Bob Gale, I forgot to mention, said at the diner, he goes, well, here's the problem. There are seven cars. Did he say seven cars or six cars? I think he said seven cars. There were seven cars we used throughout all three movies. So they have a specific car in the photo. When they realized that they couldn't get the car from the first museum, they looked at the photo again. They go, well, look, it hasn't faded away, so there's still a chance. So this must not be the car. There must still be another car out there. That leads them to Leah Thompson. That leads them to a museum. And they go to the Hollywood Museum. So we get a kind of a glimpse into that place, the Hollywood Museum. It shows all these different things, all this cool old Hollywood stuff, which, like, even scripts that have, like, writing on it. Now, to me, all that stuff is amazing because I'm like, someone actually wrote this. Someone took the time to write this and do this, and that became, you know, this movie or that movie. Like, that kind of stuff, that real life stuff, I love it. So this place has a whole area dedicated to Back to the Future. And it showed the phone book page with Emmett Brown with a note next to it saying how they spelled his name wrong. They had the original camcorder. They had the Mr. Fusion. They turned into a lamp. One of the production guys turned into a lamp, the original Mr. Fusion. They had the original photos, all the different photos showing the McFly kids getting erased from existence. They had a bunch of different things. Like, they had the Save the Clock Tower. It wasn't the flyer, but it was like a bigger version. So probably the original thing that they made. That'd be cool to have framed up actually on a wall. The original flyer, Save the Clock Tower. And they go to see the DeLorean, and it's the DeLorean from Part 3. It's got the white wall tires. It's got all this, this wooden circuit box on the hood. And this was cool because Christopher Lloyd's like, oh, see these dents right here? This is because they had to nail a piece of wood onto this so that Michael and I wouldn't keep sliding off the hood, off the roof of the car. Because remember, at one point, they sat on the roof of the car and used horses to try to get up to 88 miles per hour. So that was cool to see. And then they realize, she goes, well, you know, you could maybe, this car doesn't belong to us, actually. At one point, Christopher Lloyd made a joke. He's like, all right, he literally said, you distract the broad and I'm going to grab all this stuff and we're going to eBay. He wanted to sell all the stuff, which was pretty funny. And then they were like, all right, we'll take this car then. They're like, no, this isn't the right car. She's like, well, you know, this doesn't actually belong to us anyway. It belongs to these brothers who are in Massachusetts. And he's like, oh, cool, I'll look them up. And Christopher Lloyd's like, what do you mean look them up? He goes, we're going to do this the old-fashioned way. He hits the phone out of his hand. He goes, get rid of that portable robot you have, and we're doing the old-fashioned way. We're going to Massachusetts. And I want to take a moment right now. I'm stopped because I'm watching this on my Roku, and I have the Roku screensaver, and this is happening live as we see this. The screensaver just has a cityscape, but it has a lot of different things in it, and one of the things is the clock tower. And the clock tower is almost 10 o'clock. That is literally the Back to the Future clock tower in the Roku screensaver that I'm looking at my TV right now. And that just happened. That just happened live with you on Marchy McFly. I just took a moment. Like, that just totally took me out of things. Wow, that's amazing. Now, back to this. So they're like, well, wait. What do we care? This guy, the car is here. Why do we have to go to Massachusetts? You know, nobody has more than one Back to the Future car. Why would they have more than one? And the woman goes, actually, they have three. And that's where this episode ends, and they go off to Massachusetts to continue their quest. And they show some scenes of the other episodes where they go to Massachusetts, they see pieces of things, they go to a DeLorean plant, they go to a Hollywood, it looks like a prop area. This is so far up my alley that I can't wait to watch the other three episodes, but I just figured I'd talk about, this first one and kind of give you an idea of what it was today. Today is a real celebration of Back to the Future. Now, I did mention the cafe, the Lou's Cafe. I can't believe I never figured this out or I never noticed this before. But the calf, Lou's Calf, Calf Cafe, Lou's Cafe in 1955, right on that corner, right? Right on that corner, right in front of the clock tower, facing the clock tower, Marty, you know, sees the phone and goes in. In 1985, he drives right by the same thing. I never noticed that the aerobic studio is the cafe, and it's actually called Lou's Aerobic Studio. Now, in 1955, it just says cafe, but the menu says Lou's Cafe. So either Lou's son turned it into an aerobic studio and kept the name, or Lou is like, it's, I read on some, the some fan Wikipedia, some fan wiki that it said like, oh, Lou's 60 in 1955. Now, look, we don't know that for a fact. This is the 50s. Lou could have been 45 and he just looked 60. That's how people looked old then. So, but maybe 90-something-year-old Lou owns an aerobic studio now. I thought that was pretty cool. And I just, that was one little note that I took while watching this morning. I see 15 times this month, 15 times in a row, and I still noticed something new today. That's pretty awesome. It just shows how much I love this show. And that's it. This is a pretty short episode today. Pretty basic. No special guests. No special moments. Nothing to sing along to. But you know, this week, as I said, I'm home from work. So I'm home at work usually, but now I'm not working at all this week. So I'm looking forward to getting these shows out a little earlier. And Wednesday night, I'm looking forward to talking to my friend Eric about what else Back to the Future. So I'm done here. Thank you guys for listening and subscribing. Thank you guys for sticking with me all month long. We're not quite halfway done. We're hitting the halfway point. I feel like at the end of this episode is the halfway point. In the beginning, right in the middle of, like, tonight is the halfway point, because, again, there's 16 days left to go after this, right? Am I doing the math right? Today's the 15th. So, yeah, 16 days left to go. So my dog wants to go out right now, which is perfect timing for me to scram, make like a tree, and get out of here. So until tomorrow, my friends, you know, you can follow me on Twitter and on Instagram at Geek Mentality. You can follow me on Facebook. The Facebook page is Fans Not Experts. And, of course, the website is fansnotexperts.com. That's it. I'm done. Happy Marchy McFly 15th, everybody. And until tomorrow, here is my theme song.
This is my podcast. I made it. Geek Mentality is what I named it. And I think you should listen and subscribe. Because I'm kind of funny and awesome. I think that I'm worth your time. And I'm kind of handsome. My mom says, please listen and please subscribe. At least listen to this episode.
Fans Not Experts.
What are you looking at, butthead?